Garfield has been a pulp culture icon ever since his debut on newspaper comic strips on June 19, 1978. Ever since then, he's appeared on television, video games, on stage, and in movies. But the subject of this feline's history that I'm going to be talking about is his appearance in the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade as a giant balloon, from the 1980s to the 2000s. Garfield made his debut as a balloon in 1984 with United Feature Syndicate, or United Media, as his sponsor. The design itself, it's just a generic design, as he's basically relaxed with his iconic smile and his tail, which has a moving feature, which happens for a couple of times over the years. In his debut, he was talked about twice. One was at the parade starting line at Central Park West with Pat Sajak commentating about him, and yes, Wheel of Fortune's Pat Sajak, and when he reached Herald Square, Brian Gumpel commentated about him.
Of course, that is one of the most famous characters around these days. He is Garfield the Cat. Probably the best-loved cat in America, although he's probably more accurately described as a human in cat's clothes from his characteristics there. Eating and sleeping, his favorite activities, and apparently riding in parades as well. Told he doesn't really like to chase mice, so I don't know if that qualifies him as an official cat. So, and if you like statistics, he is going to consume 18,907 cubic feet of helium for the trip. That's only a theory, but we think that's accurate.
Still got an awful lot of parade still to go. If I keep looking up as I talk to you, it's only because I've got a cat hovering over me. Perhaps you recognize our cat. He is Garfield. You probably see him in your local paper. Jim Davis is his creator. Garfield comes to us by way of United Features Syndicate. How's that for a view?
On a side note, before the parade arrived at Herald Square, the parade's destination, there was a skit that featured Joey Lawrence, and yes, that Joey Lawrence, and a very weird clown. Not scary, but he took Joey on what seems to be his imagination on seeing the balloons inflated. Garfield was on the end of the skit featuring the late Manfred Bass, who was the parade's head designer responsible for all the floats and balloons from 1966 to 2000. Garfield will appear again in 1985, and out of all the balloons in that year, he was the one that was flying the highest, despite of it being on a rainy day.
I have a question for you. What's 60 feet high, 35 feet wide, orange and black, and hates exercise? Well, there's the answer to your question right there. And we really answered it last year when the great Garfield balloon made his debut in the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. I mean, how can you not love a cat that puts chasing mice at the bottom of his list of fun things to do? Garfield has been quoted as saying, "Show me a mouser, and I'll show you a cat with bad breath." Boy, the balloon handlers deserve a lot of credit on this day, too. It's breezy and rainy, and it's not easy getting a monster like Garfield, pardon me, Garfield, for calling you that, but getting him down the street. Garfield is furnished by United Features Syndicate, and this morning he displayed his famous appetite by having a Thanksgiving breakfast of, get this, 18,907 cubic feet of helium.
Watching NBC's exclusive coverage of the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade with a lineup that includes Shannon, Rosemary Clooney, and coming up, Philip Michael Thomas.
In 1986, he became the first balloon in the parade that year, not counting the novelty balloons before him. But one of his paws was ripped.
Well, I don't know how many clowns we have. I don't know that there's an official count in this parade, but we can stop counting somewhere in the thousands. Now, look at this. This is the third year running that Garfield has been willing to break his normal sleeping schedule with an early feeding of helium on Thanksgiving morning so he could appear in our parade. And for a cat whose primary joys in life are eating and sleeping, you can imagine the sacrifice he's making to be here today. Still, when it comes to his fans, and especially children, he may sound tough, but he's really a pushover. Furnished by United Feature Syndicate, he's also one of the most popular balloon characters ever presented in this parade. Look at him, measuring 60 feet in length, 35 feet wide. I've calculated he is capable of coughing up a 20-foot furball, but that's just an unofficial estimate on my account. He's actually the fattest float in the parade, but this is Thanksgiving, so let's not talk about waistlines. The main thing is Garfield knows we all love him.
Garfield appeared again in 1987, this time commentated by the one and only Willard Scott on his first year hosting.
Happy Thanksgiving, Rita. Thank you for the entertainment. Ah, here he comes, that son of a gun. That cat, that Garfield, that gigantic thing you see there, he's the fattest and the greediest of all the balloons. Do you know it takes more helium to inflate him than any of the others? Nearly 19,000 cubic feet. That's a lot of hot air even for me. And because he's so fat and with all that lighter than air helium, it takes 36, count them, 36 balloon handlers to keep him in the line of march. Garfield has what's described to you as 400 pounds of free lift. That means he can lift 400 pounds off the ground, or me in a suitcase. So if four kids weighing 100 pounds each tried to hold his guidelines, they couldn't keep him down. He'd fly off with them. Anyhow, 100-pound kids can't be balloon handlers. You've got to be at least 150 pounds to hold one of these lines. And all the handlers are volunteers who work at, guess what, Macy. Garfield is furnished by United Media. We love you, Fat Cat.
There's lots more live on NBC. The Great American Small Dog Float with Burt Hart and one of the best high school marching bands in the country.
Once again, in 1988, he became the first balloon of that year, but also to celebrate his 10th anniversary, even though it wasn't mentioned in the parade's broadcast.
You heard that story about David Crockett killing a bear when he was only 3? Well, Davey actually was 33. The bear was 3. For our first giant balloon, what could be more fun than America's favorite fat cat, our beloved Garfield, furnished by United Media. This orange and black striped tabby has a voracious appetite. He gulps more helium than any other high flyer in this parade. Did you know it takes nearly 19,000 cubic square feet of the stuff to get this cat off the ground? That's a fat cat.
Then, in 1989, which was the only year the parade was fully snowed, Alf was a special guest host alongside with Willard Scott and Deborah Norville, and he was lucky enough to talk about the famous Fat Cat.
Alright, I gotta tell you, here's the fat cat that I've been waiting for. Garfield the Delicious. Ha ha! Now this is the sixth time this tabby has stalked down Broadway in Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. And if my plans work out, it'll be his last. You know what? I'm disappointed. They told me it was going to be a real cat. It's made out of vinyl. You know, if I wanted to eat something that big made out of vinyl, I would have eaten Willard Scott's garment bag. Kill me. Yeah. Now, the truth is, this guy is kind of cute, all right? I might take him home for a pet if it wasn't so darn big. Could always let the air out of them, though. Look at that thing. Not enough mustard in the world. That would have fed my entire planet. You know that? Look at that thing. Whoa. Giant feline mignon. All right. Well, I think we'll go to a commercial right now while I sharpen my carving knife.
Jill Schultz and the Peanuts Gang get ready to glide by, and the Radio City Music Hall Rockettes line up for kicks here on NBC.
After the 1989 parade, Garfield was retired. Until 1992, United Media decided to sponsor the balloon again for a comeback in honor of his 15th anniversary in 1993. So much so that he became the first balloon of the parade.
What a show, what a production, what a way to start off the band, the Sunshine State of Florida. The best. Thank you, West Orange. Hey, anybody in this world who knows Garfield knows that he's going to pass on turkey this Thanksgiving and head straight for the lasagna. That's his favorite dish. I hope they're serving that where you're headed for, big cat.
Willard, you know, Garfield is not known as an up-and-at-em cat. But when he heard he was going to be the first giant balloon in the parade this year, well, he roused himself to fly down Broadway just for us. Furnished by United Media, Garfield will be celebrating his 15th birthday this year. Happy birthday, big guy, and thanks for stopping by.
Oh, that's
nice hat, Willard.
Thank you. Perfectly lovely. I thought you were going to do that.
Like he's coming down for a crash landing, doesn't he, Willard?
I think he's looking for some more food. That cat has an insatiable appetite. A cat after my own heart. And liver. And fava beans. And a good Chianti. Chianti.
He would continue in the parade in 1993, and as I stated a few minutes ago, to celebrate his 15th birthday.
Garfield, of course, is known to move at a snail's pace, but when he found out he was going to be in today's celebration, this feline made a beeline for the parade. Furnished by United Media, this kitty weighs in at a whopping 398 pounds. Willard, how about that? Talk about a fat cat. It's no wonder he needed 35 iron-handed escorts to hold the tiger. And Willard, this year Garfield will be putting 15 candles on top of his lasagna.
Hey, that means he's 15, but certainly he ain't lean. Kitty, kitty, here, kitty, kitty. I'll bet he goes through some kitty litter in his time, huh?
In 1994, which began the Brad Lockman era of the parade's broadcast on NBC, Garfield would continue on in the parade, but with a different sponsor. This time, the sponsor was Paws Incorporated.
For all you kids out there, you kids of all ages, that is, here's an authentic train car. The details are beautiful. At least we can hear the train, Willard. And I should mention that that's not a train, because the train's already passed us by. That's Garfield.
That's a pussycat. A big pussycat.
Everybody loves the wisecracking, lasagna-snarfing fat cat from Paws Incorporated. This big tabby definitely has nine lives, Willard. This is his ninth appearance in the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade.
And with all the statistics we quote on this program, I've got to tell you that Garfield uses 2 million pounds of kitty litter every week. Check out that fabulous band.
And like the 1984 skit with Joey Lawrence, Conan O'Brien, when he was still a late-night host on NBC before the Tonight Show controversy, he was supposed to talk about the inflation of Garfield. This was even proved by the parade's announcer, the late Don Pardo.
We'll be right back with Conan O'Brien and a behind-the-scenes look at how much helium it takes to inflate Garfield.
But instead...
And I think it's high time that I was represented in the annual parade.
No comment. Garfield would continue for the next 5 years. He became the second balloon in 1995, and the first balloon to survive that year in terms of giant balloons, since the balloon that was before him, Dudley the Dragon, was deflated.
It's the big fat feline himself, Garfield. The Garfield balloon is furnished, of course, launch by Paws Incorporated, created by Jim Davis, the chubby cat was born in his favorite room, the kitchen. No wonder Garfield gobbles more helium than any other balloon in the parade.
He's my kind of cat. I'm not saying this fat cat's full of hot air, but Garfield thinks his weight is perfect. He says that with all humility. As you know, he has lots of. It's probably his passion for pasta that makes him the size of 117 refrigerators. Don't you think?
Right. Why bother to actually take the food out of the fridge? Just eat the whole darn thing, Garfield.
Hey, he's as big as a dinosaur. The dinosaurs are extinct, and Garfield's still here, so he must be eating something right.
Willard the Balloon Captain Fred Rally would have to climb 6 flights of stairs to reach Garfield's ears.
And you know his favorite hobbies are eating and sleeping. Not a bad way to go. I think we belong to the same operation. Only the best, that's all.
Spider-Man, LL Cool J, and the Boys Choir of Harlem step into Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade when we return.
And again, in 1996, he became the second balloon, but not counting the deflated part like the previous.
Thanks to the Lawrence brothers. Hey, Willard.
Yes, ma'am.
Guess who I see floating down the street? Here's a hint. He's fat, kind of lazy, and has a major attitude.
That sounds like my agent. I didn't know he was going to be in this parade.
Down, boy, Willard. It's America's favorite fat cat, Garfield. Garfield may like his catnip and his cat nap, but he's managed to be a part of the parade festivity since 1984. He's provided, incidentally, by Paws Incorporated.
You got that right. And we're told that Garfield's birth weight was 5 pounds, 6 ounces. That's a big cat. But today it takes 50 Macy's volunteers to handle his 400-pound ice cream-craving, lasagna-loving feline who eats until he's, do I dare say it, cat-atonic?
Arr!
Oh. Good show, Walter. Willard.
The residents of Sesame Street, the Big Bird Balloon, and gold medalist Oksana Bayou, when the 1996 Macy's Parade marches on here on NBC. NBC's telecast of Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade is sponsored in part by the Braun Oral-B Plaque Remover. Dentists recommend changing your toothbrush every 3 months. We suggest you change it forever.
Then, in 1997, Garfield was one of the 7 giant helium balloons that survived the heavy wind conditions in the parade. The others were Arthur, Big Bird, Peter Rabbit, Rugrats, Spider-Man, and Bumpy. 5 other balloons were deflated or popped, and 2 balloons were removed because of a character that I will talk about in a future episode. As for Garfield, even though he survived the winds, however, his left back paw was damaged, and his tail was damaged overnight from the heavy winds.
And one of my favorite things, Alan Katie, is making his 14th appearance in the city that never sleeps. Here's the only kitty that only sleeps. America's favorite fat cat, Garfield. I love him. And I'm telling you, we're the same stripes, I think, when it comes to hobbies, Katie.
And they would be, Willard?
Well, you know, eating and taking a brisk nap, of course. And then eating and taking another brisk nap. And, you know, anyway, he's Paws Incorporated, so let's pause for Garfield.
He's actually a bit of a bobcat because he had some tail problems early on. Garfield gobbles up 19,000 cubic feet of helium, more than any other balloon in the parade. And when he's finished lunching on lasagna, this Garfield needs a space the size of 6 kitchens in order to stretch and snooze. How's his weight this year, Willard?
Oh, holding at 400 pounds. And I believe, judging by that 20-foot wide grin, I'd say this chilled out Cheshire thinks that's just perfect.
In 1998, when Macy's and the people of New York City had the new rules for the balloons on their size limits, the expansion of the handlers, and have 2 utility vehicles to help control the balloons, Garfield was one of the balloons that got to stay in the parade. And it was pretty exciting for this cat, as 1998 marked Garfield's 20th anniversary. But however, like the previous year, the weather was heavy winds, but lots of rain. Luckily, nobody was hurt, but some balloons were damaged, Garfield being one of them.
This past year, Garfield just deflated. It busted a chamber inside. and we had to pull it out of the parade. It wasn't because it was unsafe, it just couldn't fly.
The famous Fat Cat was not the only one that had this accident. Spider-Man, Quick Bunny, and the new Wild Thing balloon from Where the Wild Things Are had sprung leaks before they start the parade, and it's either from a lamppost or tree branches. As for the parade's broadcast on television, when a balloon does not reach Herald Square, NBC shows either a test flight if it's the balloon's debuted, or a previous year when the balloon was at Herald Square. As for Garfield, the footage that was used for him was 1996.
Well, because of some of the high winds this morning, some of our large character balloons won't be coming down the line of march, but thanks to the wonders of videotape, we're going to be enjoying how they look in a previous year's parade. And of course, everyone knows the cats do not like water anyway, Matt. But as we see, enjoying life in the laid-back lane, America's favorite fat cat, Garfield, furnished by Paws Incorporated. Garfield might feel a little extra smug today. Well, it would have been his 15th parade appearance.
Actually, this was kind of a birthday year, too, because he celebrated his 20th birthday. That's how long ago it was that he was born in Mama Leone's kitchen. And then, of course, introduced to his favorite food, lasagna. And how do you suppose he celebrated that birthday?
Gee, I don't know. By taking a long nap, I think.
Coming up, Judy Collins and pop recording star Monica when the parade continues on NBC.
But thankfully, Garfield did came back in 1999.
Garfield's favorite form of exercise may be a brisk nap, but America's favorite fat feline manages to drift down Broadway for his 16th parade, making our chilled-out Cheshire Macy senior balloon. I think he's ready for his holiday lasagna with all the trimming.
Garfield, by the way, is furnished by Paws Incorporated, and he gobbles up some 19,000 feet, cubic feet that is, of helium. No wonder he's the size of a fast food restaurant. And by the way, when he wants his food, Katie, he wants it fast, which explains his fondness for the microwave. His head is the size of 50 of them.
Garfield always leaves us with some morsels of wisdom. This year, creator Jim Davis Tabby says, never put off until tomorrow what you can eat today. I'll eat to that.
Heading down Broadway is a show band that could even make Garfield sit up and take notice.
After the 1999 parade, the original Garfield balloon was retired after being a total of 14 appearances. And yes, that still counts 1998. After 3 years of an absence, Paws Incorporated decided to sponsor Garfield back in the parade to celebrate his 25th anniversary in 2003 and the promotion of the live-action Garfield movie by 20th Century Fox that was scheduled to be released in the summer of 2004. But this time, the famous cat was brought back as an all-new balloon. This time, he gives the Macy's Parade a very big thumbs up, and brought his pal Pookie on the side. And it was not also very exciting to bring Garfield back in the parade, but he was also named Macy's Holiday Ambassador of 2003.
All right, now everybody's favorite cat and a brand new balloon. It's Garfield, Macy's Holiday Ambassador for 2003. Garfield and his best pal, Pookie, give this parade of parades a very big thumbs up. Pookie, by the way, is the size of 700 teddy bears.
Furnished by Paws Incorporated, it looks like our wisecracking, tuckered-out tabby hasn't given up his passion for pasta. In fact, Garfield weighs as much as 37,000 pans of lasagna.
That's a lot of lasagna. 2003 marked Garfield's 25th year in the comics. Next summer, he'll star in the first ever Garfield movie.
All right, everybody, the word.
Garfield once again continued the following year in 2004 to promote the home media release of Garfield the Movie, starring Bill Murray as the voice of the Fat Cat.
And parading down Broadway, everybody's favorite fat feline Garfield with his best pal, Pookie. Paws Incorporated furnishes that lazy lasagna-loving cat who prefers laydowns to sit-ups.
Who doesn't? Well, after the parade, our tuckered-out Tabby plans to chill and watch the video of his box office smash, Garfield the Movie, followed by what else? A catnap. All stretched out, ready to snooze, balloon Garfields the size of 9 king-size beds.
Garfield's philosophy, never put off till tomorrow what you can eat today. I'm following that philosophy on Thanksgiving. That is one profound pussycat. The days before high-tech and low-carb.
But you may notice his right paw is ripped because it got a little damaged to a tree at Central Park. He would appear again in 2005, but nothing really big for him. Also, his sponsor was changed from Paws Incorporated to 20th Century Fox Home Entertainment.
Okay, enjoying life in the laid-back lane and giving this parade a big thumbs up. It's everybody's favorite fat cat, Garfield, furnished by Fox Home Entertainment. He's hanging with his best pal, Pookie, who's the size of 700 teddy bears.
The Garfield balloon gobbles up some 14,000 cubic feet of helium. No wonder he's as big as a fast food restaurant. Speaking of gobbling, after the parade comes his usual Thanksgiving feast, microwave lasagna, which, as Garfield puts it, is possibly nature's most perfect food.
And as always, our tuckered out Tabby leaves us with profound words. Anybody can exercise, but this kind of lethargy takes a real discipline.
Here's a fabulous 50s flashback aboard.
Garfield would make his final appearance in 2006 for the promotion of the home media release of the sequel, Garfield, A Tale of Two Kitties.
I definitely believe. Okay, check out that nap-taking, lasagna-loving, famously fat cat Garfield and his best bear, Pookie, furnished by 20th Century Fox Home Entertainment.
Garfield gobbles up more helium than any other balloon. In fact, to satisfy his passion for pasta, Balloon Garfield would need a lasagna pan the size of about 6 kitchens. In that Weisenheimer's own words, I'm not overweight, I'm under tall.
The tubby tabby with a rude toot is totally the cat's meow for the release of his new DVD, Garfield, A Tale of Two Kitties. But will our sassy star rest on his laurels? Absolutely, Garfield will rest on anything.
California's Riverside Community College.
After 2006, he was officially retired, and that concludes Garfield's history in the parade. So in total, Garfield's history in the parade is a total of 18 appearances as a balloon. Will we ever see him come back to the parade? Well, this year marks Garfield's 40th anniversary, but I really don't know.